Let me introduce you another Kickstarter camera designed for boost recording and high quality live streaming. It's equipped with AI features including real-time target tracking that you can witness in action right now. This 4K video you're watching was captured with the help of an AI cameraman tracking my every move. No need for shooting a 360 and reframing the video later, and no need to pre-program all the camera movements as you might have seen in my MyOps review. So it's a remarkably intelligent and exciting little camera. Let me demonstrate how it excels in both recording and live streaming using your computer or simply your smartphone to go live. Let's start with a basic desktop setup, allowing you to use the camera as a webcam or a video source for any live streaming scenario. All you have to do is connect the Tail Air using a USB cable, fire up OBS on your computer and set up the camera on the control panel. Add your camera as a source, then right-click on it, navigate to Properties and click on Configure Video. Within this panel, you can fine-tune exposure settings, white balance, saturation and numerous other details. Here you can also set up framing by zooming and positioning the camera. Essentially, you can remotely move the camera on the gimbal left or right or up and down to achieve the best framing. Additionally, if you prefer, you can manually adjust the focus, ensuring the focus distance remains constant even when you step away from the scene. Of course, if needed, you can easily add a LUT by opening the filters menu, selecting your favorite LUT and fine-tuning the strength of the effect. Afterwards, you can include the camera as an audio source. However, if you prefer, you can use any other connected microphones you have with your computer. Well, let me show you the full connecting process step by step. Of course, the first step is to connect your camera to the computer. The camera comes with accessories that facilitate connections to various devices, supporting both live streaming and charging from different sources if required. Next, switch your camera to UVC mode, making it appear on the computer as a standard USB webcam. You can easily do this in the OBSBOT Start app by tapping on the UVC mode. Then you're good to go with OBS or any other apps on your computer. Some of them like Google Meet will work without having to run OBS in the background, and some of them like Teams will stream via OBS. But it's very easy to set up. Let me show you how. After configuring everything as I demonstrated, there's just one more step. Simply click on Start Virtual Camera, and then you'll be able to select it in Teams as your video source. That's it. And basically that's how you can stream anywhere using only the camera and your computer. But the more advanced features like AI tracking and HDR image come with the smartphone app, which you can use in such cases too, adding unique features to your cam connected to the computer. So let's connect the camera with the OBSBOT Start app. You've got two options for this. First, you can connect via Wi-Fi. In this scenario, choose a Wi-Fi network to which your smartphone is already connected. The camera will then link up with the same network, establishing a connection with the app. Another option is selecting cellular data. Here you'll connect the camera and phone using the Tail Air hotspot. It's the same process as connecting with other cameras, such as Insta360, DJI cameras or even GoPros. Keep in mind that in this case, while you're remotely controlling the camera, your phone won't be able to connect to another Wi-Fi network. So the basic difference is that in the first case, you have the flexibility to use any Wi-Fi network, while in the second case, you'll be utilizing your mobile data for wireless streaming. While you can remote the camera in both situations and even if you stream on computer. But it's important to know that in this case, you won't be able to stream on desktop and wirelessly at the same time. If the UVC mode is active, you can only stream on your computer using your phone as a remote controller. Moreover, within these settings, you can configure various aspects of video recording or streaming. This includes everything from gesture control and audio settings to camera configurations and, of course, your output preferences. In the media settings, you have the option to choose your frame rate. The camera can capture or stream at up to 60 megabits per second in 1080p or at lower frame rates in 4K, each with varying bit rates. It's worth noting that you can only set one 4K output at a time. Therefore, you'll need to make a decision about which output is the most important for you during a session, whether it's recording on the SD card, streaming, or sending your video to HDMI output in higher resolution. As I mentioned earlier, with UVC mode active, going live wirelessly isn't an option. However, you can enhance your webcam with all the cool features. To start, you can activate HDR mode to expand the dynamic range. Adjusting your image orientation is also possible, allowing you to use it with or without a mirror effect in your video. Additionally, anti-flickering can be turned on based on your electric network settings. If you enable AI object tracking, you can effortlessly choose any human target, animal or object to track automatically. Just draw a box around it and you're good to go. Then you can zoom in on the image if necessary, or save multiple views for the same image and switch between them. The key here is that tracking remains active at all times. Even when streaming in 1080p, you can slightly zoom in on the 4K image without sacrificing quality in your output. Importantly, all these settings will be applied to your image in OBS or any other apps on your computer, allowing you to leverage them in desktop live streaming as well. While if you turn off UVC mode, you can select from multiple outputs for live streaming wirelessly using a local Wi-Fi network or your mobile data. So you can use this camera both indoors and outdoors with no trouble, with the best option depending on your needs. By long pressing the record button, we open the live streaming setup. Through the OBSBOT Start app, we have the capability to stream up to 1080p with various bitrates. We then get the option to choose from RTMP, YouTube or Facebook with the requirement of logging into our account. On YouTube, we can input a title and configure privacy settings before starting the streaming session. For Facebook, the process is equally straightforward. We can choose from various options, such as streaming on our private timeline, going live with one of our pages, or streaming directly into a Facebook group. It's a simple and user-friendly process. And of course, in every case, we can take the advantage of the AI tracking function and all the professional settings in the app. And it's not only for live streaming, but also for recording videos directly to the removable SD card. So actually, it's two camera in one. But let me summarize the most important specs for you. The OBSBOT Tail Air captures high-quality images both in 4K and 1080p resolution, gathers more light, bringing brighter frames, finer details and less noise in low-light conditions. With the AI auto-tracking function and AI director grids, this camera is the perfect assistant for solo content creators. It tracks humans, pets, and even objects at very high speed, while efficiently and intelligently managing the real-time output video image. And while the app is very handy, you can also use gestures to control the camera. Put your hands up, and the camera will follow you. While you can also zoom in and out with a simple L shape, and start recording with an OK gesture in distance. And of course, this camera is perfect for recording and streaming too, doesn't matter if you stream on desktop or wirelessly using your phone. In this video, I walked you through the typical ways I use this camera. However, keep in mind that it offers various outputs for different purposes, including HDMI, USB-C, Ethernet, and Wi-Fi. You can even integrate it into larger projects with a multi-camera setup, linking these cameras together in a streaming camera system. I hope you enjoyed this brief review and gained valuable insights into the OBSBOT Tail Air camera. If you did, please give a thumbs up. I believe it's a fantastic tool, especially if you're into live streaming or recording as a one-man crew or solo content creator. If you have any questions or additional experiences with this camera, feel free to drop a comment. And for more creative contents and tutorials, make sure to subscribe to my channel. See you next time!